Hello and welcome to another Kubla Cubed tutorial. In this one, we're going to be talking about site stripping. So in this project, I've already brought in a site plan and scaled it, and I've already taken off the existing contours to create a surface. So we'll just have a look at that. It's exaggerated slightly in the vertical so we can get a better look at the topography. So after this, what we're going to do is create a strip. So a strip has to be in its own phase, and I'll talk about that later. So we're going to use the first phase, which is proposed one. I'm going to rename that to site strip. And I'm going to start creating a strip using the strip element here. So you just click the plus, then click on strip, and then just start drawing out, tracing the perimeter of your strip area. So you can create as many strip areas as you want with different depths. In this example, I'm going to just create a single one with a half a foot depth. It's also usually with strips, people set the batters to 0.01 because they don't want a sort of side slope on their strips. They want the calculation to be like the sides to be near vertical. So it's as simple as that, really, although there are a few other things to talk about. So here we have a site strip, and we've got the 2D area is 157,794 feet squared, and that multiplied by 0.5 feet depth gives us a volume up here of 78,893 cubic feet, which is what we'd expect. So at a basic level, that all there is. But what is very important to remember is that the strip has to take place in its own phase, because when you do your the next part of the project, which is defining the proposed elevations, you want them to be calculated not against the ground, but against the stripped ground. Now, to understand that better, is understand how the construction phases and calculation order work in Kubla Cubed, and there's a separate video about that. So if you haven't already, I'd recommend watching that one. What is happening here is we start with the existing phase, then the site strip's calculated against the existing levels. And then when we come to doing our proposed levels, we want to not compare them to the existing ground. We want to compare them to the stripped ground. So that's why we have to create another phase here. And then we call this bulk earthwork. So a simple project with stripping will have something set up like this: existing, site strip, and then bulk earthworks. You might have additional phases after this, but you always have to have the site strip in its own phase. One little trick that I'll show you, which is some people like to do, is if you've got an area in here which you want to be excluded from the strip. I've already talked a bit about how you can create another you could create another region of strip over here if you wanted to, and that one's 1 foot, so that's quite useful to know that you can do that. You can create as many strip areas as you want. If they intersect, they will be additive. So this one's 1 foot, this one's half a foot, and where they intersect, it'll be 1 foot added to half of it. So you can see that the cursor showing cuts there at 1.5 feet. So you just have to be aware of that, how that works. By the same sort of logic, you can adjust this so that an area is excluded from the strip. So we'd use a spread element, which is the opposite of a strip. It sort of adds material, whereas a strip removes it. So we go spread, and then I'm going to just draw an area in here just to demonstrate, and set that to 0.5, like half a foot. And if you understand how phases work, these elements here are combined into a single proposed surface. So what's happening here is the strip element of 0.5 is combined with a spread element of 0.5, and then the area where they intersect, they effectively cancel each other out. So it's a good idea to experiment with this, like if you don't understand it fully, like play around with the things. Pay attention to the cursor and what the information it's giving you. And it's also useful to like examine in 3D as well, so you can get a good idea of what's going on. When you master these concepts, doing strips is really easy. But if you do have any questions, post in the comments or get in touch with us on our forum.